Welcome back, my boys and girls. So previously, we put the 16-bit HT by Gamers Tech through its paces by checking out the Super Game Boy on it. And I'm a huge Game Boy fan. I love playing Game Boy games on the big screen, either through the Super Game Boy or the Game Boy Player. And I felt, hey, we check this out, seen how she looked there. It's only fair that we do the same kind of comparison on the Hyperkin Super Retron HD. So we're going to go ahead and remove the game, put our Super Game Boy over here, and test it out on this system. So neither of these systems are perfect by any means. You're simply not going to get a clone system that is 100% perfect. If you want 100% perfect, you're going to have to get an original Super Nintendo. But the point of these kind of systems, obviously, is that we can plug them in through HDMI and use them on our modern TVs. And that is pretty sweet, in my opinion. And I just want to peep these out and just do as many tests as I can with them. So today we're going to check out the Super Retron HD. We're going to go ahead and test out Donkey Kong Land. And then we're going to test out a repro of Castlevania Legends. And we're going to do a little side-by-side comparison on both. Just real quick, this shouldn't be a long video, just a quick comparison. So let's go ahead and peep that out. Okay guys, so here we go. The biggest thing I'm going to notice between the two systems here is with the Super Game Boy, the Hyperkin does want to display that splash screen. A little obnoxious, you know. We know it's the Hyperkin Super Retron HD. You don't have to remind us of that. But with that being displayed, it cuts the Super Game Boy intro, so you lose the sound for a couple seconds. And you've seen that in the comparison in Donkey Kong Land between the two systems, that the Gamers Tech HD, the intro plays fine, and on the Hyperkin, you lose the audio. So upon first boot up of the system, you always get that splash screen. If you hit reset, and I'm going to do so now, you don't get the splash screen, but you still lose the audio. As you can see here, I don't get the audio for the Super Game Boy intro. And I find that kind of odd. Is it a huge deal? No. I think it was worth pointing out just to make note of that for some weird reason, this system, because of that splash screen, wants to cut the intro, the sound in any of the intros for a couple seconds there. A little weird. But overall, my impressions between these two systems, regardless of that little issue, is they both look great. I think the Hyperkin, though, because the display is so much more brighter, it really looks good to me, especially with these games that do have, you know, these special bezels or, you know, expanded color palettes and whatnot, or custom color palettes, not really too much in the way of expanded, not with the Super Game Boy, but there are plenty of games that are made for the Super Game Boy, such as this one. It does have, you know, some extra colorization to it. And I think these games look really good on the Hyperkin. The Super Nintendo games, oversaturated and whatnot, and is immediately noticeable for a lot of people. With the Game Boy games being played on this, the oversaturation does nothing, essentially, because there's not that, you know, there's not those kind of details to wash out like you would on a Super Nintendo game. And as you see, you know, typically the color palette's only going to be about four different colors or so, depending upon if it's just standard Game Boy game or Super Game Boy game with the extended color palettes. So it really doesn't do anything to make the game look worse. I think the game actually really looks good on this display. Looking at it on the Gamer's Tech, everything's a little darker, and it's fine. It's playable. Everything looks good, plays just the way it was meant to be played. But like I said, with the Hyperkin, just a little bit brighter. The sound, besides that little issue in the beginning with the Super Game Boy logo intro thing, the sound is the same issue with Super Nintendo games. The Gamer's Tech booms. It peaks, you know, in my audio monitoring, and I've not changed anything between the two systems. It's just the way it is. And hey, I mean, you just gotta adjust, I guess. The Super Nintendo didn't have that kind of peaking action as far as sound goes. The Hyperkin's gonna be a little bit lower. So it just depends on you and your setup. If you have the Gamer's Tech, you know, you may have to adjust the volume down. If you have the Hyperkin, you may want to adjust the volume up. Just depends on you. You know what I'm saying? And what your standard settings are. But for these videos, I use the same settings for both systems, and just wanted to point that out. So the only reason I do these videos is to give people an idea. Like, I don't want to say, hey, you buy this, you buy that. I just want to show you. I have my preferences, just like anybody else is going to be, but I want to show you visually and have some audio so you can make judgment calls on your own, especially if these two systems are what interests you. So there's a couple more systems that are coming out pretty soon. Retrobit's HD offering for the Super Nintendo will be releasing pretty soon, and I cannot wait to peep that out, because that system is not just going to be HD Super Nintendo, but it's also going to be HD NES and Sega Genesis all in one, with ports for each controller. So definitely can't wait to peep that out. And also the Super NT from Analog will be coming out pretty soon as well. But we all know that's going to be an awesome system. I mean, that's going to be the winner as far as visuals go. We all already know that. But that system is very expensive. It's a very pricey offering. And not everybody's going to want to fork out that kind of money. So that's why I look at these cheaper clone consoles, the Hyperkin, the Gamer's Tech, and the Retrobit, I feel are all, you know, lower priced options. I think out of all three of them, the Retrobit's going to be a little bit more pricey, but the reason behind that is you're getting HD support for three systems, and it's not really that much more expensive. It's $10 more than the Hyperkin. The Hyperkin's $69, the Retrobit's going to be $79, and the Gamer's Tech is $49. So the Gamer's Tech wins out on price point. You know, the Hyperkin has a nice build quality, good controls. Visually, things look good. Sound looks good. You do have those oversaturation issues that you can adjust on your TV for Super Nintendo games. But I wanted this video to be more focused on displaying the Hyperkin and the Super Game Boy more so than the other systems at the moment. But when I get my hands on the other systems, we will be... Why do I keep jumping in that hole? We will be comparing them as well. Like I said, just so you can make the best choice possible for you. There's going to be pros and cons for each system between price, build quality, features, etc. And hey, that's what I'm here for. Try to help you guys out the best I can. So appreciate you guys popping in. Smash that like button if you could. Subscribe if you have not done so already. And guess what? I will catch y'all next time. Peace out, guys. Bye-bye. Boom!